Episode 1932, Broken Can Still Be Beautiful.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people. Happy, happy day. You made it through the week, and now you can breathe because it's the weekend. Today is Relationship Builders. How are you building your foundation in your marriage? What does it look like? Sometimes we feel like that it can't be fixed. Remember, broken can still be beautiful. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, no marriage is perfect, yet many strive to have that picture-perfect relationship. When the going gets tough, remember, broken can still be beautiful. Your relationship is not based on how good you look. And those looks are not in reference to your physical beauty. No, it's not. Have you ever looked at a stained glass window? Think about it. Get that picture in your mind right now. Did you know that a stained glass window with all of its color and different shapes, all different sizes, are made from small pieces of glass? That window is not one solid piece. It was constructed from many small pieces, broken ones too, that were shaped and refined and then held together by lead and a rigid frame. Think about those churches that you walk into, those huge, gorgeous cathedrals, and you see just these tall stained glass windows. They're not all one piece. You see, the beauty of that stained glass window did not come from being all one color, all one shape. It was a mixture of carefully treated and handled glass that eventually became a masterpiece. Our marriages are the same way. We can't have a stained glass window without some things being broken. We can't have that perfect marriage without some things being broken. Broken can still be beautiful. No matter how hard you try, your marriage is not going to be perfect. You can go to counseling every single day. I mean, every single day, 24/7, 365, and still you will fall short. You're still going to miss things. Why? Because you're dealing with two different individuals that have their own minds. They're bringing their own ideas, their own thoughts. But you see, that's where we can begin to make a shift in how we see our failures in marriage. We can see the failures and successes as little stained glass shapes. But when put all together with hard work and forgiveness, the beauty is undeniable. It's indescribable. Broken can still be beautiful. So let's be real. Life is not easy. Have you looked at your house lately? Have you looked at the person you're sleeping next to? Or wait, maybe you haven't been sleeping next to that person. Maybe you've actually been fighting more. You know, you probably have had more arguments, disagreements, and fights more than you've had actual sexual intimacy, or at least they're neck and neck. So what do you do when you feel like there is more brokenness than beauty? Well, you got to put it together piece by piece. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Put it together piece by piece. Think of that stained glass window. Picture it again. Maybe you've been to a beautiful cathedral. I know when we traveled overseas, our oldest, Kaylin, she was just a wee little thing, barely a year old. And my parents, my dad was stationed over there. And so we decided that this was a time. Yes, it was kind of weird. We had, you know, a small infant. And I was like, okay, we can do this, right? So my husband said, let's do it. So we went. And it was amazing. And we went and looked at those old cathedrals, you know, that had been around longer than we here in the United States have been alive and been a nation. And I just went and stood in there and just looked up and I'm like, oh my gosh, beauty. But it all came from stuff that was broken, stuff that had to be refined, edges that had to be smoothed out, all those little parts. That represents all the situations, all those circumstances, all the seasons in your marriage. And in order to find the beauty in your marriage, you have to put it together piece by piece. So what does that look like in real life? Well, number one, you have to own your stuff. Marriage is a two-way street. You must be responsible for your actions. You got to be responsible for the words. Yeah, words have power. If you haven't listened to the My Strength is My Story episode 1930 with Sharon Janes, go back and listen to that episode. Powerful episode. It talks about words. I've talked about it before here many, many times, right? You have to be responsible for your words, your thoughts. What you think about, yeah, you bring about. You want to start a fight? Oh, just keep thinking about it and it's going to happen. You got to be responsible for your body language. Are you just kind of pushing him away? Are you pushing her away by the way you look at her? The way you roll your eyes? The way your shoulders hang? The posture that you greet her with in the morning? Or the posture that you greet him with when he comes home from work? Also, you got to be responsible for your tone of voice. Do you have this motherly tone with him? Oh, honey, you got to do this. I've asked you 5,000 times. That's not going to go over well. He did not marry you to have a second mom. That's not your position as his wife. All of it matters. So own it. Own your own stuff, the good, the bad, and the ugly. I know I had to do it myself. It is very uncomfortable, but it is amazing. And yeah, all those little pieces, you start putting it together and like, oh my gosh, that's gorgeous. Own your stuff. Number two, forgive more. If you're not willing to forgive your spouse, your marriage is in for a really very rough ride. It just is. You have to be willing to forgive. Now, understand this. When you forgive, that doesn't mean that you're saying it was okay regarding the actions that were taken or the words that were spoken. That's not what forgiveness is about. I mean, literally, we can have a whole class, a whole lesson, a whole training session on forgiveness and then some. There's so much to cover. But what you have to look at it is when you forgive, it's releasing yourself of holding on to that responsibility. You control only, you got it, you. You can't make your spouse change, but you can make the change. So you've got to forgive. You've got to say, okay, I said I do to this guy. I'm going to forgive him. That doesn't mean I approve of his actions. That doesn't mean I like the way he spoke to me in front of the children. No, but I can forgive him as an individual. As a man created in God's image, I can forgive him. I can forgive her. But that doesn't mean I'm accepting of how she just torments me and putting me down like I'm her fourth child. But you can forgive her as an individual. If you don't forgive more, your heart is bitter more. Listen to that. If you don't forgive more, your heart is bitter more. You just keep building it up. You keep stacking the deck, right? That's not what marriage is about. Own your stuff. Forgive more. And number three, love when no one is watching. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. But when the beholder is not looking, you still must love. That means you don't act one way to get your way. How many times do you sit there and you're like, oh, you know, if I do this for him, then I will get this in return. But then you go out with your girlfriends and you talk smack about him. Oh, you won't believe what my husband did. Seriously? Love when no one is watching. You can't sit here and play one side and then play to the other side. Because what is that doing to your heart? You're playing with real emotions within yourself. It's a very dangerous ground that you're walking on. So don't act one way to get your way. You love your spouse right where they're at without the changes you wish for. So maybe you're like, well, Christiane, if you just hear how he talks to me, you would be saying fill in the blank. Yeah, I might be saying that. But the thing is it's not your job to change him. You can't control what comes out of his mouth, no matter how hard you try. But you can love him where he is at. You love what's in front of you. Good, bad, and ugly. And then you let God work on the rest. Pray for him. Pray for your spouse. Lift them up. Because remember, what do you control? Only you. Own your stuff. Forgive more. Love when no one is watching. You see, you are the artist in your marriage. There are many people who say, oh, I'll never be an artist. I've said it. I'm like, I'm not an artist. Come on, I'm all about stick figures. I was not good. I can color in the lines, but you asked me to draw something? Yeah, no, I fail. Just completely. But we are all artists when it comes to our relationships. You are the artist in your marriage. So where do you need to begin to refine what's in front of you? Think about all the pieces, those situations, the problems, those barriers. What can you do to work on one piece at a time? Is it a matter of loving your spouse unconditionally? Is it a matter of forgiving more and dropping the score? Or is it a matter of owning your own stuff and starting with the person in the mirror? When you take one piece of glass at a time, smooth it and refine the edges, there you'll see that broken can still be beautiful. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful, restful weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.